go, Dusty. Last piece.
Oh, come, Mrs. Snyder, I've already had two pieces. You should save it for somebody else.
You can handle that. You're the birthday boy.
That's right. You are the birthday boy.
That is true. I can't wait to put your great gift to use.
You can't, huh?
Well, I could see you and me walking on the beach in Dominica. It's going to be great. And also going to visit Sierra and Brian. I can't wait.
Yeah.
What about...
We better get going.
I wanted to go the minute we got here.
Yeah.
Your mother wanted us to have some cake. Why have you been so jumpy, Lynn?
With Josh here, running around like he owns the place? What do you think?
Is that really what's bothering you?
No. And by the way, Holden, I spoke with Franco and Angela Visconti. They'll be coming to the States probably next week to discuss some business with us.
I can hardly wait.
I'm going to throw them a real big dinner party. I think it'd be a lot of fun. Emily, you must be so relieved that the Steinbeck case is over.
Well, there's one problem. James is still out there somewhere.
How does one know? Well,
yeah.
I'm just dying of curiosity. I'm absolutely dying. I don't... How can you pretend that it doesn't bother you that Rod Landry is here in your family's home, pretending that he belongs in the bosom of the family?
Well, Lucinda, no matter what I am feeling, I am trying to keep it to myself because of Lily.
Lily thinks that what you speak is utter gospel. Why don't you sit the girl down and straighten her out about him?
No, but the thing that I think you've forgotten is that no matter what I say, it's not going to change the fact that Josh is her father.
Goodness.
Excuse me.
Oh, goodness. What?
Dear, why can you never back me up?
I'm just trying to figure out and digest everything I've heard this evening. I mean, Steinbeck is still alive. He faked his own death.
You better call Margaret.
She's been avoiding me like the plague. I don't know what's wrong with her.
Well, call
I get my eye teeth to find out what it is that's bugging.
Well, ask her to ask her to talk.
I have no luck in getting her to talk. She's communicating with me about as much as Andrew is.
Now, I'll just tell you, you can jump into the shower to try to get away from me the way you did the other night. You can run up or down the stairs. You can ignore me. You can turn away from me. You can get angry. You can shout. You can do whatever the hell you want to do. But I am not leaving until I get some answers. Now, when we were talking earlier tonight, you said something about finding relief for these bad feelings you're dealing with. What I want to know is, what kind of relief are you taking?
Mom, I really think you're taking everything a little bit too late.
I want to know, are you taking drugs?
No, I am not a druggie. Mom, how could you ever say something like...
Are you drinking?
I cannot believe you would ever, ever ask me a question like that. No, the answer is no, I'm not.
Okay. I still would like to know what you meant about finding relief for your feelings.
I didn't mean anything in particular about that. Just whatever relief that I can talk myself into, because just to get rid of the feeling that life is just not worth the hassles and the pressures that you go through.
You're at that stage in your life where you have a lot of doubts about yourself, about your life. I think you're probably trying to learn to deal with all kinds of relationships and probably really starting to have feelings that are all part of becoming a man? I can understand you're not wanting to talk to your mother about stuff like that, or maybe even your father. But you could talk to Bob, or Tom, or even a counselor. Honey, it's just that to turn to a crutch like alcohol or drugs. Well, you saw what it did to Kathy. Unfortunately, I understand that's not always a deterrent.
It is for me.
Son, drugs and alcohol can seem to give you relief in the beginning. But in the end, they can just make your life a living hell. If you could just...
Margo, what is going on? Leanne and I have been waiting for you for hours. I call the station. They tell me you left. Finally, I call Lila. She says you're on your way straight home. That was a half an hour ago.
Well, something came up at the station.
I have already talked to both Mac and Kim. I am well aware of Monica Lawrence's statement to the police that James is still alive. Now, Kim tells me that you wanted to tell me all this yourself.
Well, yes, that's true. I did. I wanted to talk to Hal. We haven't had five words.
I happen to know that Hal picked up Paul at Kim's 2 hours ago. They were going to go up and see Barbara. They've probably already been to Jennersville and back by now.
What is this, a third degree?
I am trying to find out what's going on. Then I come down the steps. I hear you asking Leanne if it's okay if you call Lisa and ask if Leanne can spend the night.
Father, I would like to go spend the night at Grandmother's. And if that's not agreeable with her, perhaps I could spend it at your father's house.
I don't want you to think for 1 minute that you're not welcome in this house. Maybe Margo can explain this whole thing now.
I just thought it would be nice if we had some time alone so that we could talk.
Talk about what? What is so important that it would necessitate Leanne's leaving?
The Emmy Award winner, As the World Turns. This portion brought to you today by new Ultra Pampers Plus, all the dryness a mother can give. And by Always Panty Liners, the ones with dry weave, because dryness is what panty liners are all about.
I'm sorry I came down on you so hard. I'm just trying to understand what's going on.
Well, I haven't been very easy to understand lately.
Okay, listen. The most important thing is that you're back. How about if I run you a bath? I'll get Nan to warm up the dinner she made.
I'm really not very hungry, thank you.
Okay. I'll just fix you a bath.
Tom. You don't mind, I'm gonna run my own bath, all right? I wanna have some time to put myself together. Leanne, I'm sorry if my suggesting you stay at Lisa's tonight made you feel like I was trying to get rid of you.
Oh, no, I do not take it that way, really.
Good.
I think it would be nice if I went over to Grandmother's tonight, if she doesn't mind. You and Margot have had so little time alone together since you've come back from Washington, and I've spent so much time with you already. Did I say something funny?
No, it's probably a good idea if Margot and I have some time alone. Just for tonight, maybe I can find out why she's so tense and talk this thing through, you know? I'm gonna give Mom a call.
True. It's very true. Right on this.
Where are you gonna get Jen from?
Find out.
What I'll do is I'll drop you off at the house and then before I swing by Margo's, okay?
It's nearly 11 o'clock.
Oh, don't worry. I'm sure she's still up gabbing away with Tom. They're discussing the whole thing about Barbara being freed. Tom's little victory goes right down the tubes, huh?
I think I'll go with you, dear. I'm very curious to know about James and the story and how it all worked out. Maybe I'll give Margot some pointers about long-lost daughters.
Oh, yeah, well, I'm sure she can use them.
Well, listen, you guys, we're gonna split.
Okay.
Happy birthday, my man.
Thank you for coming.
Many happy returns.
Yes, thank you.
Dusty,
okay.
Don't you
thank
forget you. That you're coming to my office. You can take
yes,
me up on
I'm going
that
to look
wait.
Into your offer.
All right.
Seriously, I can't wait.
Good night.
Oh.
You're okay.
Looks like you've been necking.
Thank you, Holden. Good night.
Well, Monica and her husband didn't stay very long. You losing your touch, Holden?
No, I think it was seeing you here that scared her off.
Come on, let's go. Good night, everybody.
Way to go, Holden. We should invite her to the Visconti's, my dinner party.
I don't think that would be a good idea.
Why not?
Because Craig signed Visconti in the first place. And I have a feeling that Lucinda could easily get that contract back in May if she wanted.
Well, they've been very happy with what you and Tony have done. He told me in Rome.
No, I think Holden has a good point. Which is why it's even more important that both you and Emily charm Visconti as much as you can when he's here. Very nice.
Well, I just don't understand why John and Lucinda left before everybody else.
I think I'm partly responsible
for that. Oh, no, I don't. I was talking to John. He seems very preoccupied with his children. And he's become very withdrawn. I tried to tell him that most boys 18 are like that. You know, I remember Holden. He was so quiet. He always felt like something was boiling underneath that he wouldn't share with anybody. Come to think of it, I still get that impression sometimes.
So, I don't know.
I still think it would be a really good idea to go to Boston on your spring break. We'll have a nice visit with Franny, and you can spend some time with Kathy. Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt, but Sabrina just got back from New York.
Really?
Oh, and Lisa called. She's picking up Leanna, Tom, and Margot. She's spending the night with Lisa, and they want to stop by and see Paul.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. I told them that.
Paul,
but...
Paul is staying with Hal today.
Right. But they want to come anyway.
Oh. Well, the activity never stops around here, not even after 11 o'clock.
That's what keeps us young and exhausted.
I'll be right down. Come on down, kiddo, when Leanne gets here. Say hello to her.
Okay, sure.
Shannon. Hi, it's Colin. Listen, I'm sorry to call so late. I was just wondering if you'd object to an earlier than normal start tomorrow morning.
Oh, I don't see why not. But can I ask why?
Of course you can. No, I have a few personal errands to run in the afternoon, and I don't want to lose any time on your portrait.
So, you have errands to run, eh? Duncan always gets annoyed when I use that phrase. He thinks I'm keeping secrets from him, which couldn't be further from the truth.
Where's Crowley calling at this hour?
Are you all right, love?
Yes, I'm fine. I'm wonderfully fine. As a matter of fact, I'll be ready for you whenever you get here in the morning. But right now, I really have to say goodnight. What are you doing?
Well, I'll have to remember that reaction. I'll nibble on your earlobes every time I think Crowley is taking up too much of your time or attention.
Got you in such a romantic mood, eh?
Oh, seeing you look so ravishing. And phone call from Roy Franklin telling me that the case is finally over.
Really?
Hi.
I would have thought the news that James Stenbeck was alive would upset you.
Oh, contraire, as you would say. Perhaps now someone can murder Stenbeck in earnest.
No, Duncan, that's a terrible thing even to joke about.
What makes you think I'm joking? I come from a long line of hunters, remember? What better sport to track down a loathsome character Duncan. Like Stenbeck and...
Duncan, don't. My goodness, you sound just like my image of what Angus must have sounded like before he killed Jeremy Bates in cold blood and Margaret died in childbirth.
Oh, are we back to that again? Perhaps I'll have to take your mind off of that nonsense. Put your imagination onto a much more satisfying subject.
Sure, I'll hold.
Sabrina, honey, welcome
Hello.
Home.
Hello.
Oh, we missed you so much.
I missed all of you.
Well, now, how dare you go all the way to New York without sharing that good news with us first?
I'm terribly sorry. I thought that so...
Oh, honey, I'm just teasing you. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Seth and I couldn't be happier that you've both given us your blessing.
Well, I just was so surprised you didn't go right to Chicago to be with Seth.
Well, I considered it, but I didn't want to distract him in the final stages of editing his book.
Oh.
Sabrina was saying that she had a very successful trip to New York.
Oh, good. What happened? Well, it appears that I'll be doing a gallery showing there in late summer.
Fabulous. Oh, we've got all kinds of wonderful things to celebrate.
Yes, I did say.
I'm sorry to put you through so much trouble. I'm convinced that someone was in my apartment. Yeah, well, I wasn't sure when I first called the Hughes, but then when I saw the drawer where I keep all my personal things, I was sure I was right. Well, I hope I can stay here a few days, and then in the meantime, I'll have my super change all the locks. Thank you, Officer Parker. Goodbye.
What did she say?
Well, the fingerprints don't match anything on the computer that they've found. However, they have found Officer Parker's, and she'd been there once before. They also found a few sets of what they think are a man's print, but it doesn't match anything either.
And my prints are probably all over the place.
Honey, I hope you're not going to be arrested for breaking and entering.
My son is the DA. He'll get me off.
Sabrina, welcome home. It's so nice to see you again.
It's lovely to see you, Laura.
Actually, I'm kind of happy the police called again. I was feeling a little uncomfortable at Nancy's since Lieutenant McCloskey is there to say goodbye to her.
Goodbye.
Oh, yes, your grandmother's flying over to London to see Penny tomorrow.
I hope that doesn't make you feel homesick.
Well, it might have a few months ago, but this is my real home now.
I heard about your engagement. Congratulations.
Well, thank you very much. I hope you don't mind. I know that it's late, but I did want to check my studio and drive out to the Snyders and say hello.
Well, no, go ahead. I'm sure that Dusty's birthday party is still going full swing.
All right. See you in the morning.
All right, darling. Okay. Drive carefully.
I'll go with her.
Oh, no, no, no. Why don't you stay here and relax with us? Lisa is bringing Leanne over in a little bit.
I thought Tom, Margot, and Liam were all having the evening together since it was Tom's first night back from Washington, D.C.
That's what I thought, too, but, well, Lisa didn't give me the full story, but I'm sure she will when she gets here.
I just hope...
What were you going to say?
Nothing. This whole situation with Margot, Tom, and Liam is really none of my business.
Mom, thanks for coming by to get Leanne.
Oh, sweetheart, I'm just looking forward so much to having my granddaughter spend the night with me. I can't tell you how lonely I am without Earl.
Yeah. I'll have my things together in just a minute, Grandmother.
You take your time, sweetheart.
So I know that Earl's been chasing Nick Castello, so what do we do now that we know that James is still alive?
I don't know. It frightens me to think about it. I don't like to at all. It's just that Earl is... Oh, for so many years, he's been on James' trail, and he's just made a mission in life to try to put an end to James' nefarious operations. And, Margo?
Hi, Lisa.
Oh, you look dead on your feet.
Well, I'll be. Thank you very much for having Leanne stay the night tonight.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I'm looking forward to it. Look, maybe you and Tom can just stay in bed tomorrow, sleep late, and snuggle up, and just forget about things.
I'm ready, Grandmother.
Who could that be at this hour?
Oh, hi, I hope it's not too late.
No, darling, it's not too late. It's a family gathering.
Here we go, ma'am.
Where do you two think you're going? Don't go home. Why don't you stay overnight? With Seth not here, there's plenty of room. Now stay over.
I'm sorry, Emma. I have an early appointment tomorrow.
Oh,
we'll have to go.
I'm so disappointed.
Oh, why don't you and Emily stay over?
It's okay by me. This way, Mom, I can do some chores in the barn for you in the morning.
Good. Wonderful.
I just didn't bring anything with me.
Oh, well, I can lend you something to wear.
Or me.
All right. Bye, everybody. Bye, Mom. Bye, Dave. Bye, Dave. Bye, Dave. Bye, Dave.
Don't forget to call me.
All right.
Well, what did Sabrina say? She was very excited. She said she was going to stop by the studio and then come and say hello. Isn't that nice? And then we talk about the wedding plans a little bit. She's very anxious about all that.
All right. Well, I guess I'll go up and get your clothes.
And I'll go check out Meg's room. Open the window. Get some fresh air.
I'll go with you.
So, Lily, will you still be here when I get back?
I doubt it.
Then good night. Happy birthday, Dusty.
Okay, thanks for coming.
Bye.
All right, I'm gonna go stash my loot in the car.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
Be in a second.
I'm glad you and Emily stayed for the cake.
Would have been a lot nicer if Josh wasn't here.
Please. Really, let's not talk about that, all right?
I don't know how you can even go near that guy knowing
what he
did.
He's my father, Holden.
He's also the rapist who ruined Iva's life.
I don't think Iva's life has been ruined at all.
No? Well, then how come such a terrific woman is alone with no husband and no life of her own? Every time I see Josh, I think about how he ruined my sister's life. And if you loved her as much as you say you do, then you would hate him too.
So late, but she fell asleep, so I just didn't want to disturb her. Thought I'd wait until you got back.
I'm glad you did. There she is. I hate walking into an empty place. Having Betsy's grandmother and her daughter here is the next best thing to having Betsy. What time is it, anyway? Oh, I didn't realize I was so late over at Dusty's party. But Lily insisted, and Ivan and Emma agreed to it, so...
Wow.
Yeah.
That must have made you feel good.
Yes, it did.
I spoke to Betsy after you called her tonight. She told me how proud she was of the progress that you've been making. I can see what she means.
Thank you. I wonder who that is.
I don't see anyone.
Must be in the garage by now.
I wish I could tell you what it feels like to come to arrive and realize I'm home again.
Oh,
I guess you're the young man that I've heard so much about.
Darling, this is Rod Landry. Rod, this is my husband, David, Dr. Stewart.
Hello, Rod. Pleased to meet you, Dr. Stewart. Thank you.
Well, I was absolutely nonplussed.
It doesn't bother you.
We really should have called first before we came by. I worry about you, you know? You look awfully tired.
John, you're making too much of this. You really are. I'm suffering from simple exhaustion, that's all. I just was looking forward to a nice, quiet evening with my husband, but I don't think that's in the cards.
Hey, there's light at the end of the tunnel on the Stedbeck. Why are you so tense, huh?
You know what? There's more to my life than my work.
They told the people of this town.
I think I'm well aware of
it. Yes.
There's nothing I can do about that. I did my job, and that's what
you did, and you did a wonderful job, sweetheart.
Maybe we got to run along, huh?
All right.
You know, I hate to rush you guys, but this place is turning into Grand Central Station. Yeah?
Adam Foster, U.S. Immigration. Do you have an illegal alien here named Lian Droom?
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you today by Pringles Potato Chips, now in 9 delicious varieties. And by Mr. Clean, dries virtually streak-free so your floor looks shiny wet, even when dry. We'll continue with part 2 of As the World Turns in just a moment. Now, part 2 of As the World Turns.
I am the district attorney here in Oakdale. Leanne Drung is my daughter. I've been working with Ron Stanley at the State Department on her immigration.
Darling, don't you worry about a thing. You know your father's going to just handle
it. Lisa, I have plenty of friends in Washington if Tom can.
Oh, he can, and he will.
Now, they finally broke down, and they admitted that they kept Ms. Drung in their home illegally, and then they sent her here by bus several weeks after her illegal entry on a freighter.
I am well aware of that. My daughter has told us the whole story.
Well, I'm sure we can straighten out all this tomorrow morning when your contacts are in their offices. But right now, I have got to do my duty and take her with me.
You are not taking my daughter anywhere.
Excuse me, Mr. Foster. Where would you plan on taking Ms. Drung tonight?
We work in conjunction with the local police, so I'll take her to the precinct house until we can settle this.
Well, Mr. Foster, my name is Detective Margot Hughes. I'm a detective on the Oakdale Police Force, and I'm sure one call to my superiors, and everything would be fine for Leanne to stay here tonight.
Look, ma'am, I don't want to be difficult, but my job's on the line here. Now, I'm going to have to take Ms. Drung with me to the precinct house, and I'll talk to your superiors face-to-face. Now, then maybe...
Maybe you're not hearing me. Maybe I'm not making myself clear. If you want to take my daughter, maybe you should try doing it over my dead body.
Father, no, don't say such things, please. I will go with this man. Please, I don't want to cause any more trouble.
I wonder what happened to Lisa and Leanne.
Well, if they changed their plans, I'm sure they would have called.
Kim, I'm just fascinated by these notes of yours on the show you're doing on married couples with two careers. It's going to be so exciting to see people I know on TV.
Well, by the time we do it, you may be working at the studio, and then you can see it firsthand.
I don't want to get my hopes up until after the interview.
Dan's car just drove off.
That's what you were waiting for.
Ha ha, very funny.
Feeling better, dear?
I think I'll go talk to my mother about her trip. You know, it'd be nice if you could bring Amy back with her, then Leanne and Amy could get to know each other.
You know, that's a great idea. I probably should run over and say goodbye to your mom, too. I have to leave early for the studio tomorrow.
Do you want a coat?
Just my shawl.
Okay.
I'll stay here in case Chris wakes up.
Oh, thanks. I appreciate that. Kim, can I talk to you?
Of course.
Just between us.
Of course.
I think sometimes a woman picks up on these things faster than a man. I have to confess that I found myself a little too involved in the problems between Margot, Tom, and Leanne.
Well, it's not that they're really problems. It's just a sticky situation. It's going to resolve itself, though.
I'm sure you're right. The truth is, I felt myself drawn to Tom from the first time I met him. He's just such a remarkable man. I've just warmed to him right from the beginning.
Well, I can understand what you're responding to in Tom. I mean, he is a terrific man. And he is really very much in love with his wife.
Oh, I know that. That's just one of the reasons that I respect him so much. If Victor had had one-tenth of Tom's qualities, my whole life would be so different. I know that thinking like that isn't going to make anything any better.
What happened to Lisa in the end?
Hi, I don't really know, but in the meantime, Bob and I are going to run over to Nancy's for a minute. I'll be right back.
Andy, stay with me. Keep me company.
Okay.
So, kiddo, what's happening?
I'm sorry, my mom's the only one who calls me that. You sound just like her.
Thank you. It's the nicest compliment you could ever give me.
Well, you've done a great job, Rod. I'm quite impressed.
It does look good, doesn't it? I'll never truly be able to thank you or your family for giving me this opportunity to make myself a real home here.
Well, it works.
I can afford, too.
Works both ways, you know. I sleep easier when
I realize that there's a man on the property looking after things.
No answer to Emily and Holden's. I wanted her to know that you're home.
Maybe you should try out at the Snyder's farm. The party was still going strong when I left.
Oh, all right. Honey, I'm going to put you on and let you surprise her, okay?
I'm looking forward to getting to know you, Dr. Stewart. I don't know how much you know about me, but Betsy and Danny are the most important part of my life now.
Yeah, Ellen told me that when she was in Africa.
Emma? Ellen Stewart. Oh, I'm fine, thanks. How are you? Good. Emma, by any chance, is Emily still there? Oh, thank you. Emily? Hi, darling. I have a surprise for you. Yeah, hold on.
Hello, Emily. How are you?
Granddad, is that really you? Now, why didn't you tell me you were coming and we could have picked you up at the airport?
Well, it was a kind of a last-minute thing. I had to leave the first second I had a chance, or not at all.
Oh, my. I cannot wait to see you. Oh, you have to meet Holden. How long are you here for?
Only a few days, I'm afraid. I'm looking forward to spending time with the family. Right now, I'm at Rod Landry's apartment and getting to know him, too.
Well, you know, Granddad, I hope while you're here, you'll have some time to talk some sense into Betsy.
Oh?
I just am a little worried about how serious she's getting with Rod.
Why?
Surely Grandma told you. Rod raped a young woman once.
Thank you.
Yeah, but I think that if anyone can talk any sense into Betsy, it's going to be you, Granddad. I just think she's very vulnerable after her divorce from Steve, and I don't know, I think she might not be thinking too clearly.
Well, we'll talk about that tomorrow, Emily. Meanwhile, I'm looking forward to seeing you and getting to know your husband.
Me too. Okay, I'll call you in the morning. I'm glad you're home. I love you. Bye.
I know I wasn't supposed to hear what you said about Rod, but I did. And I want you to know up front, I didn't like it one bit. My father has enough to deal with that, you turning your grandfather against him. Why don't you give your grandfather the chance to make his own decision?
Now, Lily, I don't think this concerns you at all.
You're wrong. This concerns me very, very much.
Lily, I don't want to start an argument here. I really think that you and I have enough tension between us, thank you. I'm just trying to protect my sister from making a very large mistake.
I think we've both made mistakes, don't you? I just want you to know something. I plan to go to Rod right now and tell him what I just heard, so he knows where he stands. And he can stand up for himself again. Thank you. Thank you very much. Dusty, let's go.
Happy birthday,
Dad. What was that all about?
It's not important. I'll tell you later, okay? But I think this is one thing you're not going to side with Lillian.
I come from a long line of hunters, remember? What better sport than to track down James Stenbeck and do away with him once and for all?
You're wrong about Jeremy. He'd never betray your secrets.
He already has. The Highland Spirit is in the Caribbean being pursued by the British fleet. My empire's on the verge of collapse, and all because of the bloody Englishman I hired to paint your portrait.
Give Jeremy a chance to explain. He's done nothing wrong, though, I swear.
Why are you so anxious to defend the Lord, Margaret?
Because he's our friend, and any man's entitled...
Hearing your ardent... Please makes me wonder if the rumors I've been hearing since my return are true.
What rumors?
That my wife's feelings for Jeremy run deeper than simple friendship.
Peggy, I have been a good and faithful wife to you.
I'm going to track him down like the animal he is and make him pay for his spying. And when I return, you and I are going to have a little talk about the rumors
of adultery.
Angus, no! No! Angus, come back! Angus! Who is it?
Jeremy.
I thought you left the castle last night.
I did. But I stayed at the village inn.
No, you must flee for your life. Angus is convinced you've sold his secrets to the British.
But that's insane.
I agree, but you must go.
No. I'll stay. I'll confront Angus. I'll defend my honor.
No, there's not much chance of that with Angus in such a wild spirit. Please, leave. For both our sakes.
I can't leave. I can't. I can't do much for you.
Oh, no.
I'll never... There you are, you swine.
Angus, no.
Run you through for ruining my life.
You'll have to run me through first. But before you do, I must tell you, I'm heavy with your child.
It's the Englishman's baby you're carrying. Not mine. It's the Englishman's bastard.
Sweetheart, what's the matter? It's all right. It's all right.
You have to know I would never be unfaithful to you with Colin. Never.
I will go down to the station with you and Leanne as soon as I book a flight to D.C. and we can settle this thing in person.
Excuse me. Mr. D.A., my private jet can be ready to go in an hour if that will help you.
That would be a great help.
All right, ma'am. Please.
Sweetheart, I'm going with you to the station. Let's get our coats.
Sweetheart, I know you're exhausted. The timing is not very good here. I think I have to go and straighten this out.
Yes, of course you do. I just...
Amos!
I hope you understand if I don't... If I stay here.
No, I want you to. And when I get back, maybe we can take one or 2 days off and catch up.
Well, I hope you don't have to go to D.C., but if you do, I understand. I just hope you work things out.
I love you so much.
All right, enough with the excuses.
I love you more. I thought I could love it. I can't even talk straight. I'm so dull.
Just have the jet fueled and ready for takeoff at a moment's notice.
Oh, Sabrina. I am so happy that your trip to New York was successful. It's wonderful.
Thank you very much. Though I was terribly surprised to learn that it was Colin Crowley who called the New York Gallery to suggest they give me a showing.
Yes? Well, from what you tell me about your relationship, your past relationship, perhaps
he was trying to make up for all that hurt he caused you. I don't know. I still find myself distrustful of Colin's motives. I hope I'm wrong. I didn't tell Seth when I called that Colin had anything to do with the New York show.
Well, if I were you, I would tell him. I mean, he may not like it, but I think if you delay in telling him, it could cause problems later. I mean, I know him, and he has quite a temper, and sometimes he can seem a bit inflexible, but, you know, that only comes out of his need to protect and trust the people that he cares deeply about. So tell him. Tell him now. You know, I and I, we jotted down some few ideas about the wedding. Would you like to share with
you? Oh, absolutely, yes.
Them.
You know, Sabrina, I really tried to keep my mouth shut, but Mom is right. Mom is right. Look, I understand. I really do. I understand your reasons for not wanting to tell Seth that you published his novel, that you paid to have it published.
But I really think... Can't you see how much more excited and confident Seth is now? He's even working on his second novel. How can I tell him that I paid to have his novel published when I know it could destroy all that?
Your grandfather's a great guy, Betts, just like you said. Yeah, we had a real nice talk. He was a little tired, plus I'm sure he wanted to spend a little time alone with your grandmother. They left right after we talked to Emily on the phone. Hey, I'm sorry I woke you up. I just wanted to let you know that he was here. I can't wait to see you tomorrow. I love you so much. Betsy. Yeah, me too. Good night.
Oh,
What's up? Can I get you something?
No, that's okay. We really can't stay. We just thought that you might want to know this right away.
Know what?
When Dr. Stewart called Emily out at the farm, she told him all about you and Iva.
Tom, the plane is ready. Just get yourself to the airport. I do have a lot of friends in Washington. All you have to do is pick up the phone and ask me.
I would give anything to know what in the hell's going on inside that head of yours.
Believe me. Margo.
You don't want to know.
Sorry. Tom wants to talk to you.
Hi, how's it going?
I don't know how to tell you this, but I'm going to have to go to Washington tonight with Leanne and Foster and get this whole thing straightened out. I've made a few calls, set up some emergency meetings for tomorrow morning. I should be back tomorrow.
But you do whatever you have to do, no matter how long it takes. I know how important Leanne is to you.
Well, that's true. And you know how important you are to me. Don't ever forget how much I love you.
And I love you more than I thought it was possible to love another human being. Goodbye, Tom.
Christie Brothers. Tomorrow for the Emmy Award winner, As the World Turns.